Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 131, Elements of College Mathematics, Section 2.4, Problem 3. This is problem number 3 from section 2.4. It says multiply the matrices, and they give you two matrices. So the one on the left is 1, 1 across the top row, 4, negative 2 in the middle row, and 0, 6 in the bottom row. And you want to multiply that times a matrix that has 3, 0, 1 across the top row, and then negative 2, 1, 0 across the bottom row. Now you might notice these are the same two matrices as were in the previous problem, but listed in a different order. So this is problem number 3. If you look at problem number 2, it had the same two matrices, but the order of multiplication was switched. And what you're going to see is that you're going to get a different answer. So unlike regular numbers that you can multiply in either order and get the same answer, with matrices that's typically not the case. If you multiply in one order, you'll get one answer, and you multiply in the other order, there may not be an answer, and if there is one, typically it's different. So let's start this problem. So first you want to see if there is an answer. And to do that, again, what you're supposed to do is verify that the number of columns in the first matrix is equal to the number of rows in the second matrix. And the easiest way to do that is just write the dimensions of each matrix underneath the matrices. So the first matrix is a 3x2 matrix in terms of its dimensions because it has 3 rows and 2 columns. And the second matrix is a 2x3 matrix because it has 2 rows and 3 columns. And now when you've written those, you can see that the inner numbers are both 2, so they match. So there is a solution. Now, not only is there a solution, the outer numbers, both being 3, tells me that the solution will have the dimensions 3x3. The solution will have 3 rows and 3 columns. So there is a solution to find, and I know what it's going to look like. It's going to be a 3x3. So to start this off, let me make a matrix with some big boxes that I'm going to write my work in. So I'm going to have a matrix with 9 boxes for my 3 rows and 3 columns. And after I finish the work, I'll write one smaller matrix with just the answers. But that's what I'm going to have to fill in. Now, what we need to do to fill these boxes in is multiply each row of the first matrix times each column of the second matrix, systematically match it up, do the work, and write in the answers. So I'm going to multiply the top row of 1, 1 from the first matrix times the first column, 3, negative 2 from the second matrix. And to do that, we're going to multiply first times first is 1 times 3. And add that to second times second, which is 1 times negative 2. So first times first, 1 times 3 is 3. Second times second, 1 times negative 2 is minus 2. And instead of writing 3 plus or minus 2, I'm just going to write 3 minus 2. And 3 minus 2 is positive 1. Now that answer went in the top row and first column of the solution because I multiplied the top row times the first column of the two matrices I'm multiplying. So now the next box in my solution, I'm going to multiply the top row of 1, 1 from the first matrix times the second column, 0, 1 from the second matrix. So now when you do first times first, it's 1 times 0. And then second times second is 1 times 1. And first times first, 1 times 0 is 0. Second times second, 1 times 1 is 1. And when you add 0 and 1, you get 1. And again, we multiply the top row of the first matrix times the middle column of the second matrix. And the solution we got went in the top row and middle column of the solution. So now to finish the top row of the solution, I'm going to multiply the top row of 1, 1 from the first matrix times the last column, 1, 0 of the second matrix. So again, first times first will be 1 times 1. And then second times second will be 1 times 0. And when you multiply that out, first times first, 1 times 1 is 1. Second times second, 1 times 0 is 0, and when you add 1 plus 0, you get 1. And again, for that value, I multiplied the top row of the first matrix times the last column of the second matrix, and the answer I got went in the top row and last column of my solution. So now to fill in the middle row of my solution, I'm going to multiply the middle row, 4, negative 2, times each column in the second. So we'll start with the middle row of the first matrix, 4, negative 2, times the first column of the second matrix, 3, negative 2. So first times first will be 4 times 3, plus second times second is negative 2 times negative 2. So first times first, 4 times 3 is positive 12, and then plus negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Again, the negatives cancel. 12 plus 4 is 16. And again, what I did, I multiplied the middle row of the first matrix times the first column of the second, and the answer I got went in the middle row and first column of my solution. So now going over one more, I'm going to multiply the middle row of the first matrix, 4, negative 2, times the middle column of the second matrix, 0, 1. And when I do first times first, it will be 4 times 0. And add that to second times second will be negative 2 times 1. And when you do the work, first times first, 4 times 0 is 0. And second times second, negative 2 times 1 is minus 2. And again, instead of 0 plus a minus 2, I'll just write 0 minus 2. And when you figure that out, that is negative 2. And again, I multiply the middle column, middle row of the first matrix times the middle column of the second matrix, and the answer I got went in the middle row and middle column of my solution. And finally, to finish off this row, I'm going to multiply the middle row of the first matrix, 4, negative 2, times the last column of the second matrix, 1, 0. And to do that, I'm going to do first times first, 4 times 1, plus second times second, negative 2 times 0. So first times first, 4 times 1 is 4. And then second times second, negative 2 times 0 will be plus 0. And when you do that math, 4 plus 0 is 4. And as usual, we multiplied the middle row of the first matrix times the last column of the second matrix, and the solution we got that work went in the middle row and last column of our solution. So it makes sense where you put the answer. And now to fill out the bottom row of our solution, we're going to multiply the bottom row of the first matrix times each column in the second matrix. So we'll start by doing the bottom row of the first matrix, 0, 6, times the first column of the second matrix, 3, negative 2. So first times first for that will be 0 times 3, plus second times second will be 6 times negative 2. And when you do that work, 0 times 3 is 0. And 6 times negative 2 is minus 12. So I have 0 minus 12, which is negative 12. And as you would guess, by doing the bottom row of the first matrix times the first column of the second matrix, the answer for that goes in the bottom row and first column of the solution. So the next one over, I'm going to do the bottom row of the first matrix, 0, 6, times the middle column of the second matrix, 0, 1. So first times first will be 0 times 0. And then second times second will be 6 times 1. And doing the work first times first, 0 times 0 is 0. And second times second, 6 times 1 is 6. And when you add 0 plus 6, you get 6. And same reasoning, we multiplied the bottom row of the first matrix times the middle column of the second matrix. And the answer we got for that went in the bottom row and middle column of the solution. And finally, one last box to fill in. I'm going to multiply the bottom row of the first matrix, 0, 6, times the last column of the second matrix, 1, 0. And when I do that, first times first is 0 times 1 times second times second, plus second times second is 6 times 0. And first times first, 0 times 1 is 0. second times second, six times zero, zero again. So we'll have zero plus zero, which is zero for the answer for that box. And we got that by multiplying the bottom row of the first matrix times the last column of the second matrix. And the solution we got went in the bottom row and last column of our answer. And again, that is the answer, but it's typically not shown with all that work. So the final answer I can write next to this here would be 1, 1, 1 on the top row, 16, negative 2, 4 for the middle row, and negative 12, positive 6, 0 for the bottom row. And that's the answer for that one. And again, notice this is a very different answer that we got from the previous problem number 2. We multiplied the same matrices but in the opposite order and got a very different answer than what was in the previous problem.